Transmission begins.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
This is the Josh Tolley Show on the GCN Radio Network.
Welcome back to the show, folks. Hour number two is upon us. If you want to be part of it today, 1-800-259-5791. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, all those fun social sites, and of course the website, joshtolley.com, joshtolley.com. All right, so let's take on Russell Simmons. Everybody knows who Russell Simmons is. He's the founder of Def Jam, a man who has made tens of millions of dollars through the... advocating violence and handgun violence and drug dealing and prostitution and all that other sort of bad stuff that just corrupts the soul and destroys communities. But now he's come out and said, well, he's had enough. The Colorado shooting has gotten to him as well. And he has an article that he penned, or I guess it's an opinion piece that he penned for Huffington Post. And the title of it, and I'm really hoping he didn't come up with the title of this, the title of it is, "The NRA Ain't Gonna Punk Me." Yeah. This is how it starts out. The NRA stands for National Rifle Association. It was founded in 1871 with the mission of creating rifle clubs comprised of mostly Civil War veterans to improve their marksmanship. Today it has membership of over 4 million people with an annual budget of around $220 million, $20 million of which is spent on political lobbying. It no longer focuses just on rifles. Now, that's not really a surprise. Everybody knew that and, you know, can't really go after him for that either. But he talks about how the NRA has played a role in the Clinton administration, the Bush administration, and has fought the banning of certain weapons and armaments. But now he weighs in and says, you know, this whole idea behind the shooting in Colorado and Gabriel Giffords' shooting in Arizona. He said, let me break down two high-profile shootings. The gunman in the Gabriel Giffords shooting in Arizona used a 9mm handgun, killing 6 and injuring 14. The shooter had a 30-bullet magazine with one in the chamber and was able to get off 31 shots. It was during a moment when he had to reload his weapon that 61-year-old Patricia wrestled him to the ground and stopped the massacre. Well, wait a second. Let's just stop here, because if you remember, Mayor Bloomberg, who is proving that you need to stay out of New York City because he just wants to put your life in danger, he said that, well, citizens don't run in. When shots are fired, cops run in. And, of course, it's untrue. It's actually the opposite. Cops run in after the shots have already been fired and, you know, there's a crime to be investigated. But this disproves it, doesn't it? 61-year-old Patricia, a citizen, ran in and tackled the shooter. I just wanted to throw that in there because here Russell Simmons is proving Michael Bloomberg wrong. Thank you, Russell Simmons. Okay, back to the article. Contrary, the shooter in the Aurora Theater shooting had an AR-15 semi-automatic assault weapon with a 100-round drum, along with two handguns and a rifle. He bought 6,000 rounds of ammo and loaded up on body armor, all which he bought legally over the internet. The AR-15 has the capability of shooting 50 to 60 bullets per minute that would pierce through a steel door. The shooter killed 12 people and injured 58 before his gun jammed. The two police officers who first arrived on the scene would have been outpowered by the shooter, as they only had handguns and shotguns. Their lives were potentially saved by the jammed weapon. Both instances are horrific. Both instances should never have happened. But in the case of Aurora, the shooter was able to injure or kill 50 more people than the shooter in Arizona. It is so difficult, he continues, for me to swallow the argument that if we ban assault weapons, people will just find a way to continue killing people in alarming numbers as they do now. We might have saved multiple lives and stopped the injury of dozens of others if the shooter in Colorado didn't use the weapons of his choice. Now, he continues to point out, is this true? Hold on, I'll get to it in a second. He continues a little bit later in his piece. Well, I hate to break the news to you, he says, but there are mass shootings in Chicago every weekend. There are mass shootings in New York City every weekend. There are mass shootings in Los Angeles every weekend. Matter of fact, every 31 minutes, a black child or teenager is shot in America, and the media doesn't mention it, and everyone else keeps it moving. And we only want to mention the word gun reform when white people are killed. My heart is heavy for the victims in Colorado, but I cannot be silent because every politician in Washington and around this country are afraid of the NRA. No other country in the civilized world allows this to happen. Only in the land of the free, where politicians can be legally bribed and our democracy is for sale, do citizens have access to weapons of war. Well, I am not a politician, so the NRA can't silence me, and they certainly ain't gonna punk me. Oh, maybe he did come up with the title after all. So he goes on and continues, you know, if you want to fight the NRA with me, blah, 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 blah. So is Russell Simmons right? Of course not, he's not right. And of course we see mass shootings where in places like Norway, where citizens aren't allowed to have the weapons of war. Meanwhile, he doesn't take into account the Swiss, who all have weapons, and that's why nobody bothers to invade Switzerland. Matter of fact, the government issues them to them, so he's wrong about that, too. We're the only nation that has weapons of war. No, we're not. Where do people get this stuff? Honestly, this makes absolutely no sense. His entire premise here. The premise of, well, see, the NRA needs to go away so we can outlaw these terrible weapons. Let's think about this. We outlawed drugs, right? And there has become this illegal drug trade, right? Where even your daughter's best friend in high school knows a drug dealer. How did that work out? So this whole idea that you can ban products that are going to continue to be manufactured only raises the profits and the motives for people who want to sell it illegally. That's just math. So do you really want to create an arms trade, an illegal black market arms trade? Is that really what you're after? And besides that, besides how that just is stupid on its face, Russell, you should know better. You're a businessman. Besides that, the idea that everybody's being shot in America is just ludicrous. And I like how he links the fact that every 31 minutes a black child or teenager is shot in America. Are they shot with assault rifles and people wearing body armor? No. Then don't link the two. If you really want to stop shootings in America, then we look at where those children are being shot. He mentions Chicago. He mentions New York. He mentions L.A. Well, guess what? Where are law-abiding citizens most apt to face resistance in getting ownership of guns to protect themselves? Well, I know it's Chicago, New York, and L.A. Is that a coincidence? See, this is what Russell Simmons and all these guys don't understand. The bad guys are always going to get the guns. Well, Josh, he bought them legally over the internet. Okay, so if we made them illegally or illegal, you don't think he would buy them illegally behind the mall?
Well, I didn't think about that, but don't point out the obvious, Josh. He bought these over the internet.
So everybody who bought these weapons are out shooting people right now and we're just not hearing about it? Is that what you're saying? Oh, you mean bad people do bad things. Why can't we get that through our head, that bad people do bad things? How about all the people who are murdered with knives? You know more murders happen with knives? I don't know about you, but the last time I went out to dinner, they still gave me a steak knife. Russell, ban knives! Russell, I am calling upon you to ban knives in America. They are far more dangerous than guns. And if you don't push for a ban on knives, Russell Simmons, then you're actually a hypocrite and you don't understand the issue, so don't weigh in on it. I'm sick and tired of people who just want to have some sort of emotional or political move. Kind of like a bowel movement. They just want to have some sort of political or emotional movement on America. And they just spew it on all the rest of us, and it just stinks up the joint. Russell, you're smarter than this, and I expect more from you. Don't pull a Bloomberg. We'll be back right after this.